Hello, my name is Chelsea from the Book Coven, and today I have a little tiny review for you for The Witching Hour by Silver Ravenwolf. Now, this book, The Witching Hour, I did really enjoy it. I switched between the ebook and the audiobook, just depending on whether I was in the car, basically. And I really enjoyed it. It is for, I think, a more matured witch, not for a baby witch. I think you'd be a little confused or lost if you're very new to witchcraft and you tried to dive into this book, because she kind of already assumes some of the things that you should know about certain herbs and stuff. But it was also very, very informative. So I've been having trouble finding books that are specifically not for baby witches. There's so much available for new witches, and that's fantastic, because I've like dove into as many as I could. But, you know, the more advanced you get, the more it becomes a little daunting to just constantly hear over and over again that this is how you meditate and this is how you ground. And it's like, that's all great stuff, but let's move on. So this book has a lot of stuff that I hadn't even considered before, and she goes in depth. There's so many different spells that you can do that are in the book that she's tested, and she's gone through stuff that she knows works, which is great. There's not a lot in the ways of, I guess, story. There's not much meat to the book. It's just a lot of spells and a lot of different types of spells for different things. And one thing that I think the book is also good for is if you're trying to sell your witchy services, because she gets into a lot, or even if you're just trying to do some spells for friends, like to help someone who's sick get well. In a lot of the spells, probably the majority of them, she talks about how to cast it for someone else. So if you're looking at, you know, starting a business with that kind of thing, or if you're just looking to help a friend, she gets into how to cast it for someone else, as well as how to cast it for yourself if you need. So it's definitely good for that type of witch too. I really liked it. I think it's best if you get a physical copy so that you can mark down all the spells that you want to try. The ingredients that she lists aren't too crazy. There's a couple things that are a little much, like needing cemetery dirt and stuff like that. But she tells you like which ingredients are poisonous, the best way to get some ingredients, the different ways that you can get them. Talks a lot about healing magic and about connecting to your power, which is great. And it's just very informative. And I think if you're looking for a boost in your spell work, this is a really good book for you. And if you're looking for some additional spells that have already been tested and tried for other people as well, then this is a really good book for you. But yeah, that was The Witching Hour. Good book. Highly recommend for the more seasoned witch. But thank you so much for watching, and stay excellent.